Welcome everyone to this live stream here, the regular daily fun that we are doing here. So what was I doing? I was updating the Linux kernel here in our T2 from 5.1.15, also this also 16 to 5.2. That is out yesterday. Also, I think there is a typo. This probably should not be .1. Anyway, this is not yet committed. Anyway, so you see you can combine your regular IT daily routine schedule stuff with some fun stuff, because you've seen the Ryzen build, AMD Ryzen 2700. Actually, we can double check only on this channel live checking Linux proc CPU info for, yeah, 2700, I think 65 watt part. And as you've seen, so we built this last summer, I guess, nearly a month ago, a year ago. And this was not only my first PC mainboard in in maybe 10 years time. Also the first with RGB lighting, because back in the days it wasn't a thing. And so I already messed with this. Normally this, if you don't disable this in the BIOS, it's just flashing around there, although you can disable this. And since I had this, I was thinking I could actually, but first of all, I find this slightly stupid. Second of all, I thought maybe we can do something useful with this, like showing the CPU load or something of that sort. Actually, thinking about this, as stupid as I found this on the motherboard, I'm actually one of the very first who did RGB lighting. So I've built this here probably 20 years ago. And this is my own RGB lighting here from back in the day when you did DIY stuff. So just some 8 LEDs, 2 red, 2 green, 4 yellow. 8 because 8 bits, and this went straight here with this resistors to the parallel port. This of course being directly the motherboard. A connector here with a flex ribbon cable thing. And I had this probably screwed in a, what is it, 3.5 inch floppy slot like that. This actually was inspired, actually I wanted to open this before we live streamed always. Doing this here. Actually, this was inspired from the B-Box, to be honest. So for those who didn't remember, this B-Box was a computer from the B Corporation, which also made BOS. Back in the day, actually, fun fact, I had a personal copy. The only thing of all the vintage basement stuff, the only thing I don't find is my original copy there of, I think it was 199 Deutschmark or something. Would have been really nice to have. Maybe someone has thrown it away there. Maybe my father thought it's worthless shit. Anyway, so this B-Box, initially they had a PowerPC, although maybe there was also something with an AT&T Hobbit or something. Maybe we should Hobbit. Yeah, so initial prototypes equipped with, two AT&T Hobbit processors and three AT&T 9300 8 SDSPs, and then of course the production later prototypes then switched to a PowerPC 603 with 6633 megahertz. And then later, because so first of all, I even found this relatively cool, although it's a little bit vintage looking by modern standards, but you see here the two lines of LEDs, and they also show the CPU load. Not sure if all had dual CPU, but at least some had or something. Also one LED was a hard drive indicator. And I found this particularly cool because it had so much hackable interfaces here. This is a whopping huge picture though. You see plenty of ports to have fun with, also not only audio but also MIDI and all this sorts of jazz. Also I thought this blue metal case was quite professional looking. Anyway, so inspired from this, so actually although I sniffed my nose a little bit about this LED lighting, I was actually maybe one of the very first who did this kind of thing back in the day, even before this was a cool and amazing thing. And not faking this, I even, so you can trust me, I did not build this here this weekend. This is just from my spare part box. And speaking about crap in the basement, so I have even one case modded here, just like the B box. You see, I don't make this shit up. This is my real with some proper stickers, AMD, Athlon, and this kind of stuff. And you see this 8 same LEDs with holes drilled there in the case. just for your inspiration, so case modding and RGB lighting before it even was a thing. And of course, I'm not going to connect this Parley port thing. So on Linux, of course, you can just bit bang. I had a small program, I probably still have it somewhere, just writing this 8-bit values for the LEDs and then the 8 parallel bits here on this parallel interface just drive the LEDs directly, and you can just write here to dev par port or LP0 or whatever that was in DevFS and non-DevFS. Coming to the point, so I saw this LEDs, and on Windows, of course, you can control this. And I actually, did I even show this picture? Getting confused here maybe with my screen setup. Anyway, so I did some Googling, and some people figured out that this is connected on the I2C bus, on this SM bus, system management bus, where you can also connect all the motherboard, like usually the sensors, like temperature and this kind of stuff, I think. So you can drive this relatively easy. I'm actually surprised that this is not more of a thing. Actually, this is not the comment I wanted. Let's reload this. And so this is just a matter of writing the right values to the I2C bus there. And some people have done this for us. So those are apparently connected. Even the, if you have RGB memory slots, which I don't have because why should I? They are at, usually maybe at address 70 to 74 hex, left, most, right, in the center there, and then what, left, most, right side, anyway, something of that sort, and then also an external logo, back panel, right side, motherboard, LED strip, and so this should be at 66 hex, and they try to force bit banging here all those I2C addresses, and made here a map of which of those work and which do not work. And there is some Rust code. This is why Rust is really in the title. I can't make this up. Someone has written, oh, not this one, that one. And so here's some Borealis, whatever. And one thing to note, so of course, cargo, yeah, you name it. And because this is an AMD, certainly AMD Ryzen, so on Intel, this probably just works on an Intel board from ASUS. Because we have the AMD edition here, apparently the Linux driver does not have here support for the I2C PIIX4 here from back in the day of vintage galore of Intel Pentium Pro kind of stuff. So this is why this fits here. I had to rebuild the kernel anyway of this my regular office kind of virtual machine work here. And I added this patch here because otherwise without this patch I would not have this dev I2C. Is it even hopefully on, that is even on screen, amazing. I2C like zero or something of that sort. Now that I have, why did the terminal stuck? Anyway, yes, you see a couple of I2C devices. These are also I2C, what? Anyway, this is also like AMD GPU maybe and all kinds of other stuff. So if you have an AMD board, you need to patch your kernel for this. Also, I'm totally surprised that this is still not yet in the kernel. Maybe I sent it myself in. Always wondering why this stuff is not coordinated better, so much for people telling me not sending enough stuff upstream ORS. So rebuild the kernel, no running, uname 5.2, not making this up, just compiled here 1325 just for the lunch break, and lo and behold, this stuff really works. And you see this patch is also, I probably just commit this to T2 here just for the fun of it, because why not, I guess. And then I git clone this here to, what was it, something, Borealis. Of course, cargo, cargo build here for this Rust Jest. This is why amazing that we have amazing Rust support in T2. And yeah, you see, actually, this is funny. Why does it, this is strange. I did this as root, so stupid. And yeah, even this amazing micro dependencies, even for this, you need here random libc, autoconf, semver, render, whatever. A lot of dependencies by even byte order and void and bitflex, you name it. I made the mistake, I built this as normal user. There you see it is amazing that it's installing this in the home directory .cargo by default. So now I have this build artifact in my René home directory and now also as root. But anyway, documented nicely on YouTube that this stuff is in there. And then you can directly run this with cargo, which is a little bit stupid. So this accepts here some RGB values. So like 10, 20, 30 is RGB values. And this indeed writes out here using I2C 0 and 4 apparently, and has here some identifier or something here out of the motherboard. Total LED count 7. And then of course the LEDs change here that you may or may not have seen in this amazing full HD view. So this Rust code is slightly not as amazing. We can also run this. So if we run this, let's change the scene here to RGB. Also, by the way, maybe you learned something that you can run this stuff directly with cargo run. Before today, before I read this, I always did here target debug and then what? Oh yeah, Borealis here. And so RGB, so like 200 RGB, and then this stuff turns red, as I hope is visible on full HD. So as it, of course, not yet as impressive, but this Rust code is simply not more impressive, which is of course slightly stupid that it sets all LED values at once, and then yeah, people write beautiful Rust code that doesn't really do much more. What I would want is to have some LED meters here or something. This would be the most useful, because in my opinion, this RGB lighting is total stupid, that it's just blinking around some animated nonsense without any value. And if I would want to use something like that, I would want to have some something useful. Then you also see, if you use this as a data center stuff, you at least see the load. I have not yet, also slightly stupid, right? 7 LEDs, who is installing their 7 LEDs? Could they not make it 8? Maybe I should count them if these are really 7 or whatever. But yeah, can't make this up in 2019. All you get is 7 LEDs when in 2000 you already built your own 8. But is it a hair here? Just anyway. And not yet sure how I encode this, because 7 LEDs, so 7 LEDs are not even enough for the cores, as these are right now 8 cores with 16 threads with the Ryzen 2700. So I can't even use, like, have all the LEDs map all those cores one to one from core 0 to 7 and then modulate the LED brightness either with a brightness or from blue to red or some fun. Leave me in the comments below how you would use this. I mean, besides that, as I said, just decorative piece, I find this a little bit waste of resources. But encoding, there's something useful, like your load, network load, CPU load, hard drive load. But yeah, a pity that they have only 7 LEDs, but I really need to count them through if that is true or not. And then I would also need to modify the Rust code here to accept more than one LED. Is of course really funny. They write here all the Rust code and then all it can do is set all the LEDs at once. The code, by the way, is here. Aura controller. So this is how Rust looks. As I said here already, enums, again with some strange derived debug, partial equal, like, whatever. And some name string, controller, vector, use size, LED count here. So yeah, is this so much more amazing than C or C++ or Java? Let me know in the comments below. I'm certainly open to hear this. This is funny, okay, controller. Yeah, function, connect. So yeah, not really sure here about all this kind of, looks a little bit hard to type if you ask me, but yeah, anyway, at least it works. Also, you see here, this is writing initialize in static mode. So I saw already from the other values you can program, there are also some animation patterns. So then I think this microcontroller kind of stuff can do the animation itself, I guess. And you can set it to static mode. And with static mode, you can set here those values, like you want to display red and then it's displaying red. Or you can pre-program some animation pattern, apparently. And you're not really sure if this is the most amazing you see, I find this again, a function identifier, our result string, so this is probably the return value, I would guess. Use standard, yeah, also foreign function interface, C-string, everything a little bit fragile here, is it amazing? Really looking for your comments, and also self, like write dvert here, so what does it even identify? Yeah, so this is self SMB bus, right? I mean, you can read this even without me having here studied Rust in depth, and then this is apparently some kind of fancy return construct, like this is also okay something, whatever this is, this okay? Yeah, you see also modern code, then you even need to research and what's this okay, but I would guess this is some fancy return statement something, maybe with logging or whatnot. And yeah, also, is this amazing nowadays, the code so elaborative with controllers and whatnot, if in reality all you need to do is write some byte values here on your I2C bus. This is also why everything becomes larger and slower, because you need to write huge frameworks around your LED controllers. I should also point out there is a more fully featured open Aura SDK that however is much larger, and here's some C hash or at least Visual Studio C++. Yes, it's actually C++. There you, if you want to do this stuff yourself, and here are at least also some memory controller stuff like Crosshair controller for writing the special values here to that. And also, yeah, you see super slow here, 500 Mbit or 400 Mbit, and takes quite some while to load. So yeah, C++ code, the other was ROS code, tell me what you find more readable. And yeah, this is just a little bit update here from mixing serious Linux update work with testing out latest and greatest RGB lighting trial and error that I had already on my to-do for quite some weeks already. Let me know if you find this amazing, what you would do with this. Do you find this an amazing development that most PC boards have RGB lighting now, or useful or not, thumbs up or down, and how would you encode this? It's of course really a pity that it's only 7 LEDs. But again, the next one will have 16 cores, and then I would need 16 cores anyway. So at least then you could theoretically still, we could still map this not using cores, but load from LED 1 to 7. And yeah, not yet so sure. Anyway, you see also in previous times when I had this, I always only had one CPU. I never had an SMP system until I guess maybe my G5 dual core was my first dual CPU system, because cheapskate. But yeah, back in the days this was super easy. Nowadays with 8 cores and 16 threads, or soon 16 cores and 32 threads, slightly difficult to map this load. But yeah, looking forward to your comments. I hope you learned something, and if you want to do RGB lighting on Linux, now you can, at least if you are willing to DIY stuff yourself a little bit. Also, you can attach there more, of course. You can buy aftermarket RGB lighted cooling pumps and stuff, but this also means you can DIY stuff. So I could make my own LED matrix here with some I2C controller and attach this to the I2C bus, of course, but that's probably a project for another week.